Hey everybody, Rich here. Podcast attempt recording number five. I've been trying to record this thing. Running into tech issues because tech sucks. It just does. I would appreciate commentary on this because this is something new I'm trying. I'm releasing it on YouTube first and maybe onto other mediums later. But for now, YouTube, and I am using my phone. I'm just using Samsung voice recorder on my Galaxy. I'm not even using the the microphone thing on the earbud. I tried that. That sucked. So I'm just using the phone directly, and it sounds okay. From you're gonna hear room noise, and if I type, you're gonna hear that too. I'll try not to type too much. Anyway, subject of this podcast, what's it going to be? Well, being in these interesting times that we live in right now, can't really go to the guitar store. What are you going to do? Well, I'll give you some options. Let's talk about the basics first. Picks and strings. Now, of course, you can get your D'Addario, your Fender, your Ernie Ball, your GHS, your Dean Markley, your whatever strings from Amazon or eBay. That's never a problem. Picks, same thing. You can get your Dunlop Tordax, your Clayton, your Dragon pick, your whatever you use, Fender pick, etc. I've actually been favoring lately the Dunlop Tordax 73, 0.73, excuse me, millimeter. I may try the 0.60 or even the 0.50 because I'm kind of liking the thinner ones more these days. I like a flappy pick, what can I say? Seems to bring out more of the string strike, so to speak. But anyway, aside from that, I mean, you know where you can get your picks and strings, but let's just say you want some specialized strings. Well, now before I mention any of this, I'm going to say any company I mentioned in this podcast, I'm not sponsored at all. No one paid me to say any of this stuff. If you'd like me to pay me to say stuff, I would appreciate it. If you want to want me to mention your band, your company, your website, your whatever, yes, I am entertaining the idea of sponsorships. So, if you want to send me cash to say this show was brought to you by Joe's Crab Shack in Kenosha, Wisconsin, I'll be happy to say that if you in fact own Joe's Crab Shack in Kenosha, Wisconsin. I don't even know if there is a Joe's Crab Shack, and I'm making that up. For all I know, there probably is a joke. I probably just gave some dude free advertising. I suck. Anyway, if you want, anyway, so any company I mentioned, they didn't pay me to say nothing. So, that being true, okay, let's just say you want a very hard to find set of strings. Well, there's only one website for that. That's juststrings.com. I will give you an example of something that's tough to find. If you go to juststrings.com and try to find a 12 string nickel flat wound set that will fit properly on a vintage Rickenbacker 12 string, sometimes I say Rickenbacker, sometimes Rickenbacker. I think it's actually Rickenbacker. I'm not sure. Anyway. So if I'll say Rickenbacker, if you want to find that perfect set of flat 12s, which is what they did use when they recorded the song Turn, Turn, Turn by the Byrds, BYRDS. For those of you that know that song, if you got your Rickenbacker 12, but you're like, I can't get that sound. What did they use? They used 12 string flats. That was what was around in the 60s. But that's what was used, I should say, on the Rickenbacker 12. You go to juststrings.com and search for the Pyramid brand 12 string flat wound set. It is $41 for the set. Yes, it is, because it is very specialized. And if you want to get that, sometimes if you want to get that sound, you're going to have to go and pony up some cash to get the, because the nickel-plated stuff, the round wound, it ain't the same. It's anyone who plays Rickenbacker 12s knows exactly what I'm talking about. You cannot, or even if you play bass, there's no comparison between a flat and a round as far as the tone that comes out of it. It's totally different. So the point is, if you're looking for something different, something cool, look for string brands you never heard of, so on and so forth, go to Just Strings. And you can't find, there's so much stuff that they have that is not at Guitar Center, not at Sam Ash, not anywhere in a brick and mortar. So even if you could go into guitar stores right now, if you want to get specialized strings like that, you got to go to Just Strings to get it. And yeah, there is some stuff that's also on eBay and so on, but yeah, try to find those, someone that stocks those pyramids regularly. Just Strings got them. So that is but one example. So if you want the specialized stuff. So anyway, let's talk about the rest of the guitar now. So you can't go to the guitar store right now because of the pandemic situation. Oh no, what do we do? Well, what we do is that we look at places to buy stuff online. Well, what are you going to buy online? Do you buy entire guitar or do you part together a guitar? Now, I honestly think that parting together a guitar is more fun. And we'll start with the, actually, I'll talk about both. So let's talk about going from cheap to expensive here. Now, I'm not going to talk about custom luthier built. You can do that if you want, but you're going to spend like 4 grand. I'm not talking about spending 4,000. I'm talking about staying well under 1,000, under 500 and something. We'll start with the real cheap stuff, which is, of course, AliExpress. Now, how cheap can you go just to get a body and neck? Well, first of all, we'll talk, what type of guitar are we talking about? Electric guitar, of course, but what type of guitar? Strat. Why Strat? And I'll tell you exactly why Strat. Because, first of all, you have the most choice. And second, the most availability. You can get yourself Strat parts pretty much anywhere in the world, which is great. You don't have to custom order it for any specific country, unless you're buying Fender specifically, and I'll talk about that in a moment. But the deal is that, yeah, you want to get yourself, you want to build a guitar for yourself. What's the easiest possible guitar to build? It's the Strat because all the parts are readily available. On AliExpress, if you search for Stratocaster, you won't find anything or you won't find much. However, if you modify your search and you go to AliExpress and you search for ST guitar, as in the two first letters of Stratocaster, S and T, like Sierra Tango, then you start finding stuff. You'll find the bodies, you'll find the necks, you'll find the electronics. You can search for ST pick guard, ST body, ST neck, just anything ST, or just ST guitar, and you'll find all the stuff that you want. Or if not all of it, a good like 80, 90% chunk of it. And how cheap does it get on AliExpress? Well, I've seen body and neck. This is no electronics, no tuners, no anything. Just body and neck. $25 each. $50. Shipped. So you want it cheap? That's how cheap it gets. And what's the problem with doing this? Well, the biggest drawback to going cheap, it's not the body usually. Actually, it's only one part of the body. And that's the neck pocket. If the neck pocket isn't cut right, yeah, you can fix that. But the other thing which you can't fix is if you get a bad neck. And what I mean by a bad neck, what makes a neck unusable is if it's twisted. On a new neck, that almost never happens, even the cheapest of necks. But if you are willing to level frets, file fret edges, install your own nut, have the appropriate tools, and I'll talk about that in a second, to just do basic woodworking and metal filing. Then you can pretty much buy the cheapest ass neck you can find and make it something great. The arguably, when you're parting together a guitar, the most important thing you can own is tools. And you can go to Stuart McDonald, stumac.com. If you want to overspend, go there. But you can get yourself, you should have quality tools, quality sandpaper. Like for sandpapers, you need to have 220, 400, 600, 1000, and quadruple aught, as in 0000 steel wool, which basically feels like cloth. That's for polishing. You have those sandpapers and that steel wool, and you're in pretty good shape. If you get yourself some good metalworking files for a fine metalworking for fret edging, and you get yourself a fret edge ruler and a straight edge, I mean, yeah, you'll spend something like about 50 to 100 bucks on tools, but worth it. Absolutely worth it. Now, anyway, you can part together on the cheap an entire guitar from AliExpress if you got every single thing that you needed to put a Strat together. Well, first of all, I should say you can get an entire guitar for $75 from Ali, but if you want to part together the guitar, you can get it for under 200. And yes, it's not cheaper to part guitars together, but it is more satisfying, and you get more of a guitar that you want in the end. So it is worth it to go through the it is kind of a hassle, but it's worth it. My next guitar may be a parted guitar. I'm thinking about it right now. But let's just say you don't want to do that. It's like, okay, well, I don't really want to do that. I want a complete guitar. Can't go to the guitar store. What do I buy for a Strat? The only two choices I've seen that really offer the best value for the money are Rondo and Guitar Fetish. Rondo with the SX brand, that's letter S, letter X, and Guitar Fetish with the Xavier brand. You could count Slick brand in that with that, but it's got that fake age relic crap. So, but Xavier does not. Now, with the Rondo, and I'm looking at their website right now, I'll try to remember to pipe up screenshots for this in the YouTube video for this. Anyway, SX Hawk, MN, meaning Maple Neck, Ash, NA, meaning North American, $175. And you get a three-piece swamp, American Swamp Ash body. And it's about 8 pounds, 25.5 inch scale. Let's see, I'm just looking up the 21 fret, basically on par with a Squire Classic vibe. I would say so. Natural finish guitar. SX Hawk is a good one, and like, arguably, and now they do have other SX Hawks. There's one with an alder body that is one in a kind of a pea green. There's one in a vintage white with two P90s in it. There's one in a Lake Placid blue. There's one in a three-tone sunburst. They even have one here, two of them, in fact, that are semi-hollows. They figured out how to make a semi-hollow Strat for $149. Well, that's pretty cool. Now, that's just the strats. That's the bolt-on stuff. But what is the best value guitar that Rondo has? Well, it's obviously, at least to me, it's obvious. It is the Agile AL3010. That's a Les Paul. It is, hold on, I'm just looking at, there it is. $325. Agile AL3010 SE CSBF, which means Cherry Sunburst Flame. It is the only knock against this guitar I have, and there's only one, is that it's a boat anchor. It's about between 9.5 to 10 pounds, but it is built almost identical to a Les Gibson Les Paul traditional. That's why it weighs as much. It's not weight relieved. What you get is a solid mahogany arch top body, bound body, bound neck, bound headstock, Grover Rotomatic tuners, Tunematic bridge, Alnico 5 humbuckers, Graftech tusk nut. Incredible value Les Paul. Set neck, no bolt on. I mean, and a 13.7 inch fingerboard radius, so flatter than a Les Paul. Not a problem here though. And it is gorgeous. It is a gorgeous, 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 gorgeous guitar. And it sounds good too. There have been guys that have been demoing this guitar on YouTube for years. All you have to do is search for Agile AL on YouTube. You'll find people demoing this guitar. What? 325, which means it's cheaper than an Epiphone Les Paul Standard. And you get all the binding. You get the, was it abalone or perloid? I think it's abalone inlay. Hold on. I'm just reading it right here. Does it say? It's a very ornate inlay. And they individually hand. Oh, forgot. South Korea guitar. Not Chinese, not Indonesian. South Korean built. Which matters. It's good. Trust me. Agile AL3010 SE. Why don't I own one? Too heavy. That's quite literally the only reason I don't own one. But this thing is right up there. Effing gorgeous. All the stuff that makes for a good Gibson Les Paul traditional, it's all there. So anyway, and it's 325. Now, if you go cheap with the Strat, pre-built, prefab guitar, 175, 149 to 175, not including shipping. And if you go Les Paul, you can go with the SX Callisto. They do have cheap bolt-on Les Pauls, but why bother when you can get the Agile? Oh my God, so much better. Now, okay, on the guitar fetish side of things with their Strats. Oh, now these are 179 to 199. It's the model Pro 870 or XV 870. And what they have over Rondo colors, they got all, they got the good colors. Seafoam green, black, British racing green, Fiesta red, and by the way, maple or rosewood, for the neck. Capri orange, ice blue metallic, metal flake gold. You know what a gold top Les Paul looks like? Imagine that in a little lighter hue, a little more flake to it. Not the Dick Dale color Strat, but close, close. Just the right amount of gold flake. Gold flake Strat, white pickguard, maple or rosewood board. Monaco yellow, sonic blue, surf green, seafoam green, vintage cream, natural. They even have a dark ash looking one, which is like, oh, it's Mary Kay white. I mean, Xavier's got all of these colors right now. What else? A vintage sunburst, which is the two color, no red in that, which I actually like better. Daphne blue, candy apple red, and I think that's it. But what a selection! And these are good guitars. These Xavier makes great stuff. Their Strats are, oh. So if you like the Rondo, now of course Rondo, they with the SX brand, they have the semi-hollow option. I think. Let me just take a quick look. Now Xavier does have semi-hollow, but they don't have semi-hollow Strats. Semi-hollow Tellys, yes. I think. Hold on. Yes. The Pro 845 is a semi-hollow Tele, but semi-hollow Strats, no, they don't got that. But Rondo does. What's the problem with these two companies? There's only one problem, and it is the return policy. If you don't like it, you got to pay shipping twice. Now, I'll explain to you what that means by reading Rondo's return policy, which is almost identical to Guitar Fetish's return policy. Here we go. If you received an incorrect item or items are received damaged, it must be returned within 10 business days of receiving the item to get a full refund. Items may be returned for any other reason within 30 days of receiving, but will not have shipping charges refunded. Now, I'll explain to you what that means. What that means is that if you get a guitar from either of these two places, well, okay, I'll just say from Rondo, because I haven't read over the Guitar Fetish one entirely, but it is there. With the Rondo, and the Guitar Fetish shouldn't differ too much from this. The Rondo policy states if you have a guitar arrived damaged, then they will pay for return shipping to take it back. If, on the other hand, you buy the guitar from Rondo and you just don't like it, you got to pay return shipping to send that back, which means you pay shipping twice. You paid for it the first time when you bought the guitar and received it. You paid for it a second time when you had to return it. That's the only thing that sucks. But you know, might be worth it, especially for the Agile AL3010. Go to rondomusic.com and just look at that Les Paul, and I think you would agree with me, it's worth the risk. It really is. Even if you had to pay shipping to return it, I mean, just remember, it's heavy. This is a heavy guitar. So you're looking at between 9, 10 pounds, solid mahogany body, set neck construction. If you know the Gibson Les Paul traditional, you know this guitar already. Basically, same thing, more or less. So anyway, right. That's the two thing. That's the next level up. Now, what's after that? Let's go back to parts now. Let's go back to strats. The next level up after going AliExpress or then Rondo or then Guitar Fetish, which, by the way, you can part guitars together through them if you wanted to. They have all the pickups, all the pick guards, they got bodies, they got necks. So if you wanted to part together a guitar solely through Guitar Fetish, you totally can, because they're not just a guitar shop. They do part, obviously, they do a lot of parts too. But the next step up from that is Stratosphere. Now, Stratosphere does have their own website, stratosphereparts.com, although most of you are probably familiar with their eBay store. And chances are pretty good a bunch of you listening to this probably have bought from Stratosphere before. It's a good shop, it really is. The cool thing about Stratosphere is that if you want actual Fender parts, used Fender parts, as in very barely lightly used Fender parts, necks, bodies, electronics, everything, they got it. They do that for Gibson too. They also have their own brand, Stratosphere brand. So if you want to, for example, if you wanted to part together a Fender guitar, or if you just wanted the Fender neck, I would honestly say if you want to get a Fender neck, get it through Stratosphere. If you get it through Fender themselves, you will pay so much more, and I honestly don't think you would get anything. Okay, let me just put it to you this way. If you get, let me talk about Fender for a moment here. If you get the Fender standard Stratocaster neck, that's $249. If you get, that's the Mexico build. If you get the American standard Stratocaster neck, 22 medium jumbo fret, $549.99 before tax, before shipping. Now, I'm going to read to you something directly from Fender's website on this neck. You ready for this? Here we go. Because, and again, I am directly reading from Fender's website on this neck. Because Fender genuine replacement necks have not been mounted to guitar bodies, nut slots must be cut by qualified personnel. Other installation processes may be required, such as fret work, fitting the neck to the neck pocket, and other instrument setup procedures. Your local FMIC, that means Fender Musical Instrument Corporation, Authorized service center can install genuine replacement necks. Find authorized service center locations near you in the support section of fender.com. Now, the crazy thing about that is the part where it says other installation processes may be required, such as fret work. Why would you need to do fret work on a brand new neck you paid $549 for? Well, Fender says you might have to. And that's if you buy direct from Fender themselves. They just openly admit that, which is odd. Right. Which is why I say, if you're going to get a Fender neck, go to Stratosphere. If you absolutely, positively must have a Fender branded neck. Okay, if I go to Stratosphere and I go shop by category, and strat neck plates, oh, did they sell the, oh, there we go, necks. And okay, there we go. Some of these you will spend a ton of money for, other ones not so much. For example, 2020 Fender Player Stratocaster neck, which that's the Mexico build, Pal Ferro, $199. Okay. Fender USA Custom Shop, 1969, Relic Stratocaster neck, $12.99. Just the neck. Then that comes with tuners. 2020 Fender American, this is the big headstock one, Fender American Performer Jazzmaster neck, and tuners, $399.99. Now, granted, these are all official Fender necks. They were parted from other guitars, most likely. They're not fakes. Stratosphere does not do fakes. I can confidently say that. They're a real deal. You're getting real Fender neck. I honestly would buy from these guys before actually buying from Fender.com, because I just would. I mean, I see the exact neck I'm going to get. They show photos of all of them. And yeah, so, and even if I did like price low to high, how cheap can I go? I can get a Fender Squire Classic Vibe. Yes, they do Squire too. Squire Classic Vibe 70s Strat neck. That's the one with the big headstock. This is the new model, $99, so $100. They also have the licensed necks too. So if you want to do all parts necks, you want to do that. It goes all over the place. Mighty Might, they got a few of those. And yeah, there's like, here's another one. Here's a 2020 Squire Mustang neck, $120. I think the cheapest for a actual Fender neck, which would be a Mexico. I'm just going running through these right now. Probably about 200. I think that's the lowest you could possibly get. Taking a look. Squire. Yeah. Maybe I should have prepared before I started recording, Richard. Anyway. Oh, come on. Let's try page 8. Oh, there we go. Oh, yeah, that's right. Fender Player Strat Modern Neck, $199.99. Yeah, I think it starts at $200 if you're going to get an actual Fender Strat neck. Mexico, that is. Yeah. Okay, there we go. Yep, it's $199 for, 2019, 2020. And these are, basically new. So, sure. Go to Stratosphere to get your Fender neck. I think you're going to get a better deal, and I think it's a better buy. So if you got to get the Fender neck. Now, that being said, what if, let's talk about something else before we talk about what neck I think is you should buy if you're going to put some real money into it. Let's talk about tuners first. Now, in the tuner world, there's, of course, Godot, there is Grover, there is Wilkinson, but I think a brand that is known by bass players but not known by enough guitar players is Hipshot, as in hipshot.com. Hipshot, and you will spend at least $80 for a set of these. They're the guitar tuner upgrade kit. These guys got tuners that put other guys to shame. I've actually met the guys at Hip Shot personally back at NAMM 2015 when I went during that year. They have amazing machining. They have amazing product. I have nothing but good things to say about Hip Shot. And it's like I said, the bass guys are the ones that know. The reason bass guys know Hip Shot so well is like they're top seller. I think their top seller is called the Hip Shot Ultralight. And the reason it's called the Ultralight, if you've ever held four tuners from a Fender Precision Bass in your hand, not on the guitar, but actually just before installing on the headstock, if you physically held them in your hand, you would see how damned heavy they are, even though they're open back, open gear tuners. And then you compare that to the Hip Shot Ultralights, you're like, oh, that's why bass guys use these things so much, so because they're so darn light. And not only that, but they have amazing good ratios on them, and they're just great tuning stability, and it carries to the guitars. Whether you're doing it for Strats or Les Pauls or Telecasters, what they offer, Hip Shot, I honestly believe you do totally get what you pay for with Hip Shot. And I love the fact you can get open gear tuners on a Strat. They're called the classic open guitar tuning machines. They have the closed ones too, but I love seeing that open gear on the back. And you can get them in chrome, black, gold, nickel, satin. And you have a choice of three string post lengths, 18-1 tuning ratio, 10 millimeter, 25/64 inch. And they just work. They're fantastic, and like I said, I got nothing but great things to say about Hip Shot. But I should say this too. You know, if you got a Fender guitar, that Fender does that thing where they do two pilot holes for every tuner, and none of the upgrade tuners will fit those holes. Hip Shots will. It's called the Directro Fit. It's $88 for the set, but it's made so it will exactly fit those pilot holes in a Fender Strat headstock. And it's an exact fit. And it's locking. So if you want to get that locking set and you want it to exact fit, no holes drilled, which alone is worth the price right there. And not only that, but you can get it in staggered post or non-staggered. Oh my God. You see why I gush about Hip Shot so much? You can just direct order this directly from Hip Shot. And oh, it's beautiful. So if you went to Stratosphere and you got yourself a Fender neck, and then you go to Hip Shot and you get yourself the Directro Fit guitar tuner upgrade kit. Oh my God, what a combo. What a combo. Yeah, you're going to spend a lot. You're going to spend like $80-$90 for the tuners and $200 for the neck. So in effect, $300 just for neck stuff. Worth it? Yeah, worth it. If you're going all Fender. If you're going all Fender. Now, that being said, here's where I think you really need to dump the money into. If you're going to, let's just say it's like, all right, I want to spend some money. I want something good. I want something real good. And I'm going to part together the best possible thing I can part together. What do I get for a neck? Warmoth. Now, for bodies, you can pretty much get whatever you want, as long as it's a decent wood. A decent cut of basswood, or a decent cut of alder, or a decent cut of swamp ash. Whatever you like. But when you want, I think the only thing above this grade would be either Fender Custom Shop, or if you had a luthier personally build a guitar for you out of a really good premium cut of wood. But the tier right below that is Warmoth. And Warmoth, you can do so much. You are going to spend, I'm going to talk about cost up front first. You're going to spend at least $300 for one of their Strat necks. Now, they do more than just Strat necks. They do Strat, CBS Strat, Jazzmaster, Telecaster, Tilt back strat, which means the headstock's tilted back. Don't even need the string trees on that one. Don't have to do staggered tuners. Kind of cool. And one of the coolest options that they offer is the conversion strat neck, which is a 24 and 3/4 inch scale, as in 2 4.75 inch scale strat neck. Warmoth makes it. You can order it right freaking now. That's cool. So if you wanted that Gibson scale on a Fender guitar, on a Strat body, all you got to do is buy the Warmoth neck. It's there. The only thing you don't get is the decal on the headstock. It's the only thing you don't get. Now, Fender they don't make a 24 and 3/4 inch scale Strat. At least not that I know of. Well, they probably do if you call the custom shop, but man, whatever. Why would you spend $4,000 on that when you can get a $300 neck from Warmoth? See what I'm saying? And you can get it with nut. You can get it with tuners, Schallers or Gotos, I believe. You get all the goodies with this. It's fantastic. And another thing I really like about Warmoth necks is the truss rod hole location, which is actually on the side, facing the bottom horn. It's a nice location for it because it keeps the headstock. You don't have any truss rod hole on the headstock, but you don't have to take off the neck. So you get to keep the vintage Strat look without having to take off the neck every time you want to do a truss rod adjustment. And you don't have that cheese wheel at the butt of the neck either. It's a cool look. It's a great solution by Warmoth. I think it's cool. I really do. So when you want, and of course you get all the options available to you. You can go with roasted maple, you get the tiger, bird's eye, tiger stripe, whatever. I mean, they got all that stuff. You can choose species of woods. It's crazy wood you can get from Warmoth. Now, if you want to shop Warmoth on a budget, what I would recommend is searching the in-stock necks rather than making a custom order. You save a few bucks that way, but not really that much. In the end, you're still, for just the neck, you're still going to spend at least $275. You'll go there and you'll see the prices. They'll say, oh, it's starting price at 153 or 145 or 175. But then when you add in the stuff you want there, it's like, oh, I want this nut and I want these tuners or that, 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 that. It's going to end up being 275, $300. So, but just look around and see what you can get from that. I would readily buy one of these before a Fender neck. As a matter of fact, even if I had the money for it, yeah, I would still go Warmoth first over Fender. I mean, I know I'm bashing on Fender like crazy here, but it's like, see, with a Fender neck, the fact that they say on a $550 neck, yeah, by the way, you may need to do fret work. I mean, come on. That's just, and I know that can be for any neck that you order, but with Warmoth, I would be shocked, honestly shocked, if they delivered a neck with bad frets or one high fret. Because I mean that's their jam right there. This is what they do, and I haven't even mentioned all the bodies that they do. Have you seen their new body colors? Northern Lights, Maui Surf, Nebula Burst, Tahitian Sunset, and Fades, and crazy, really high quality body finishes. Now, granted, if you did a 100% Warmoth build, which some guys do, you could easily blow $1,000 over a Warmoth. Yeah, you could. You could. Should you? Well, if you have the money, you can if you want. Now, there is one final thing I'll say. I'm sorry, I gotta type for this one. Sorry. Now, if you want something, this is, and okay, we're gonna get out of parting a guitar together and talk about buying a prefab. There's two companies I can recommend for this. where I am 100% sure you will get something good out of the box. One you can get for mid price to upper mid price level. The other one, yeah, you're gonna go well into four figures. So first one, Schecter. Schecter prides themselves, and they say this a lot, on doing United States inspections. Now they do it way better than most other companies do. They look at every guitar, every single one, even the cheap guitars, even the $299 ones in Guitar Center before they're shipped. This is why Schecter is placed so much better compared to other guitars they just do. I would not hesitate to buy a guitar direct from Schecter. I think I actually I do this. Oh, hold on. I gotta type again. I'm sorry. I don't know if they sell direct. I don't think they do. Oh no. Well, I just read on the website. We will be temporarily closed as advised by the state of California. During this closure, we will not be shipping and well, forget that. Okay, can't buy from them right now. Okay, so but if you can get one shipped from Sweetwater or Guitar Center, pretty much guaranteed a good guitar. The other one, and formerly known as, although they still make this brand, formerly known primarily as Carvin, is Kiesel Guitars, Kiesel. Some of you instantly know that name, and Kiesel makes some crazy, crazy, crazy good stuff. Their Delos series bolt neck standard and headless guitars, whether you get it with the head or headless, oh my God, it's quality on another level. They have always sold direct. They don't do Guitar Center and never have, as far as I know. It's the quality of what they make is just it's like I said, it's on another level. If you're going to spend the money. And by money, I mean at least bare minimum 1,250 bucks. Although you can get some for as cheap as 1,000, but okay, we'll just say bare minimum 1,000. If you're willing to put four figures out for a guitar, you're like, I just want something that's as perfect as I can get for what the money I put into it. Kiesel. And if you don't want to spend a grand, Schecter. I can't say the same for Fender. I can't say the say for Squire or Epiphone. I think the only other one what was that other brand? I think it was Duesenberg. I guess I'll have to do that for another podcast because I've already gone on to it. How long have I gone on? Let me check. 43 minutes. Oh, almost 44 minutes. Well, if you've hung around for this long, thank you so much. I appreciate it. So anyway, there are your options. You've got AliExpress, you got Rondo, Agile, Rondo with Agile and SX. You've got Guitar Fetish with Xavier. You've got Stratosphere, Warmoth, Schecter, Kiesel. So believe me, the guitar store is not at, well, you can't do Schecter direct, but you will be able to at some point. When they open up back again, and hopefully that will be soon. So anyway, that is it for episode one of this podcast. I don't even have a name for it yet. I have to think of a name. Maybe someone can suggest a name. I don't know. So let me know what you think. If you hung out for this long, hey, thanks. I appreciate it. Take it easy, guys.